Let's look at the solution to our false sharing quiz. We have two blocks, a block that has A, B, C, and D in it, and a block that has X, Y, Z, and W in it. We're looking for which of these, if any, have false sharing misses. So let's first look at this one. There is a read X and a write X. The first will be a miss. The second will also be a miss. Both of these are compulsory misses. X wasn't in C0's cache. X wasn't in C1's cache, so they have to be compulsory misses. Read A here is also a compulsory miss. This block wasn't in C2's cache. Finally, C3 is writing to B. This block wasn't in C3's cache, so this is also a compulsory miss. So in fact, this sequence has no coherence misses whatsoever. All of them are compulsory misses. Now let's look here. This is a compulsory miss for C0. This is a compulsory miss for C1. This is a compulsory miss for C2. And this is a compulsory miss to C3. So regardless whether we had coherence or not, these four accesses would be misses because each of these caches needs to fetch the block for the first time. So there are no coherence misses in this sequence either. Now let's look here. C0 reads X. C1 writes to X. This invalidates X in C0. This invalidation needs to happen in order for X to be written in C1. C2 now writes to W. That invalidates the data in C1's cache. The data in C0's cache was already invalidated at that point. When C0 tries to read X, the reason it doesn't have the data in its cache is because C1 invalidated it, and C1 was accessing the same word. So this is an example of true sharing. We got invalidated because somebody was trying to write the same word that we were accessing. So this is actually a sequence of three compulsory misses followed by a true sharing coherence miss. So in this sequence, there is also no false sharing, so none of these should have been selected.